I'm calling this special meeting of the Common Council of Town of Quartzsite to order on Friday, January 14th at 1 p.m. I will give the invocation. Bob, will you give the pledge?
Bro.
Lord, we ask your guidance as we come here to make decisions affecting the people of Quartzsite. We ask this in his name, Lord. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Will the clerk call the roll, please?
Mayor Foster?
Here.
Vice Mayor Cowell?
Here.
Councilmember Anderson?
Here.
Councilmember Kelly?
Here.
Councilmember Lizarda?
Here.
Councilmember Lucasen?
Here.
Councilmember Winslow?
Here. Reports and announcements.
First of all, I want to thank everybody that's here for coming. And my hat's off to Vice Mayor Cowell for suggesting this new board. It's a great thing. We've needed it for a long time. And we're very enthused about getting this board going. First of all, we know this time of the day is very difficult for the working folks to get here for the meeting. The Health and Development Board is their next special meeting on their agenda. They're going to vote on changing their meeting time to Thursday early evening at 5 o'clock. So that's something that you folks could keep in mind. Perhaps your meeting could be right after that at 6 o'clock. Thank you.
Any other announcements? Being none, we'll go to new business. Alex Papp.
Mayor and Council, this is discussion and possible bid award for the Quartzsite Gateway Signage and Landscaping Project. You'll see attached a list of the bidders. And Mr. Triguna Israel, a principal engineering, is here to answer any questions you might have.
Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to award the bid for the Quartzsite Gateway Signage and Landscape Project to Nickel Contracting LLC, amount of $299, for an amount not to exceed $299,416.15.
Second. Been moved and seconded to award the bid to Nickel Contracting. Is any discussion? No discussion? I have some questions. Ms. Pat?
Yeah.
What is the status of the HERF fund that we're paying this HERF fund?
This was a budgeted item, Mayor, and was included in the budget that the Council voted on it this past year.
I understand it, but since we borrowed so much from HERF in the last year, I'd like to know the current status of the HERF fund. How much cash on hand do we have?
I can get the finance director and she can answer that question.
Would you do that, please?
Certainly.
I'll give it out.
She's not here today.
Oh? She's not here today. She is off.
This item has nothing to do with HERF fund. It has to do with the grant that we received.
No,
is that right, Mr. Triguna?
Mayor, council members, the grant has a 94.3% federal reimbursement and a 5.7% town match.
Who are you talking? What's your name?
Triguna Israel, Principal Engineering Group.
So there is some HERF money going into this project then?
The matching funds.
Right. And what would that amount be right now, approximately?
about $18,000.
Okay.
Can proceed or?
Well, we gotta wait on, she's not here.
She's not here.
So if there's no one else in the finance department can answer this question?
Sure, because you just got this information from the minister.
I just got a spreadsheet from Heidi yesterday, and it showed that there was funds obligated or budgeted this year, but I'm not aware of what was spent.
So nobody really, there's no on-hand bank account that we have for her fund right now?
When we, our account is what is called fund accounting, so all the monies, whether they are HERF, whether they are grant, whether they are water and sewer, all go into the same account and are broken out by fund.
Right. And I'm just questioning, since we found that we owed HERF $2.7 million from last year, and whatever additional borrowing has happened this year, that we have sufficient funds to pay for this and the Plymouth Avenue job, which is all HERF funds.
We have it, and you get a bank account statement every 2 weeks, Mayor.
In the HERF fund?
In the total funds.
Well, we don't want to spend general fund money on this, do we?
We can't. This is a HERF project. It is not a general fund project.
Okay.
It just seems to me that we've discussed this thing with this HERF fund almost every meeting we've had. All of this was discussed by this council at one time and was all fit into the budget. And it seems to me that we've had numerous explanations about this HERF money, and I think we're just beating a dead horse here. I'd like to see us move on and let's get something done.
No, I have not heard an assurance from this staff that the HERF fund itself has sufficient funds to be obligated with this in the Plymouth Avenue beautification.
There's more than $1 million in the HERF fund at this moment, and it showed on your last council packet.
Okay, that's what I asked. In that case, then my question is answered. Any other discussion? Any other? None? Then we'll go to the vote. We'll do this by roll call. Clerk, call the roll.
Mayor Foster?
Nay.
Vice Mayor Kell?
Aye.
Councilmember Anderson?
Aye.
Councilmember Kelly?
Aye.
Councilmember Lizarga?
Aye.
Councilmember Lucasen?
Aye.
Councilmember Winslow?
Aye.
The ayes have it. New business number two.
Mayor and Council, this is discussion of possible appointment of the following positions to the Vendor Swap Meets RV Park Municipal Board. There are five positions open at this point, and for each one we have volunteer interest statements. And the first one on the list is the vendor representative, and there are four names attached: Kenneth Lucci, Douglas True, Richard Trustee, or Douglas Stewart. And you have those volunteer interest statements attached.
Do I have a motion?
How are we going
to
work?
We need to get them to introduce themselves first.
Yeah. Okay. Kenneth Lucci here in the chamber today. Any one of the four here, raise your hand. over here, and we'll take you one at a time. Come up to the podium, introduce yourself.
I'm Doug Stewart with Grill Guard here in town. Been a vendor here for a little over 8 years. And I think that, you know, I could do a good job giving the little input, you know, basically it would help the town, help the vendors, you know, which would, it, things have to work both ways for everybody. And I think that's the most important thing, you know. It's not, I don't think we as vendors, we realize that, you know, certain things have to happen for it to work for the town as well as the vendors. It's not just a one-way street there. I appreciate your consideration. Thank you.
Just a moment. Anyone have a question for this gentleman?
We can ask questions.
We can discuss things before we make motions. That was determined when Mr. Sims was here, so that's perfectly legal.
Again, thanks for consideration.
Wait a minute. I think Mr. Lazara has a question.
Oh, sure.
Mr. Stewart?
Yes, sir.
Can you give me just a general brief idea of what your business entails?
I make windscreen, a manufacturer. I make windscreens for RVers. Barbecue grills, and my background is I came out of the import-export sporting goods business in a rather large company. I'm semi-retired.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't do this. We do this. We're in Quartzsite because we love Quartzsite. We're not in Quartzsite because we're here to make a lot of money. We're on your side.
Is Quartzsite the only place you've been?
Yeah, Quartzsite is the only place I've been. I mean, we have, you know, do a lot of business on my website and all that, but Quartzsite is where we are in the wintertime.
No public discussion, though, I'm sorry.
Any questions?
Any other member here have a question for the
country? Is this?
I forget.
Okay, thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
We'll go with you next, sir.
My name is Doug Crew, and I have Paleo Enterprises here in Billings, I'm from Billings. I've been in Quartzsite for almost 14 years, growing from a small thing to a large building in Prospectors. I've been a member of the American Federation of Mineral Societies, the Northwest Federation, and worked with clubs all over the United States, and worked with a lot of the rock and gem vendors in Quartzsite also. And I feel that there needs to be a little more communication between the vendors and working with the city and various projects that involve both.
Any questions for this gentleman?
You do gem and mineral?
Yes.
Which building are you in over there?
I'm in a metal building next to the big cactus.
What was the name of your company again?
Paleo Enterprises.
Paleo?
Yeah. Okay. Full fossils. Being retarded, that's where I sit most of the time.
I thought that might be. I just wanted to
start that. At Quartzsite, your only vending place? Or
no, I do some shows scattered throughout the West Coast and Montana. We're retarded, and this is just kind of retired, and we're just a supplement income. So.
Any other questions? Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
My name is Richard Tresty. I've been a vendor in Quartzsite for going on 23 years. I like it here. I think Quartzsite has got a lot to offer. I belong to the Quartzsite Gem and Mineral Club, the Metal Detector Club. I work with Seals Rainbow Garden. I also work with Operation Hero Comfort. I'm a non-resident. And my glass is always half full. And I think we got a lot we can do for the city of Quartzsite. And I sell mineral concentrates, gold nuggets, gold jewelry, antiques, any number of things. I do it all over the country. And I'm willing to spend the summer if that's what it takes.
Oh, wow. Any other questions for this gentleman?
I just got the same questions as I have for the other ones here. You do gem and mineral then as well?
Yes, I do.
And you do travel throughout the country?
All over the country, from the East Coast to West Coast, from North to South.
Okay, so vending is your full-time occupation?
Vending is my full-time farm.
I assume you've vended for many sites in the town. Where are you currently vending?
This year I'm doing just the powwow.
Okay.
And then I do the metal detector club meetings. I do the gem and mineral shows with the mineral club. We've got a show going in Mesa this weekend. It's all over.
Okay. All right, thanks. Any other?
I don't have a question, but may I just make an overall comment? Okay. Now, the folks that have applied for this, thank you so much, and the ones that are not seated on the board today, we encourage all of you that have an interest, please do attend the meetings. Do partake. Because all the meetings are open to the public. And I'm sure the folks that are seated on the board will appreciate your input. Thank you very much.
I will make one other comment. And during the public discussion on this board at a previous meeting, it was discussed that this meeting will be to authorize the board and get it moving, but that at that point the board was recommended that they might increase their membership. So the fact that you don't get chosen tonight, once the board convenes, your application still can be considered for expanded membership on this board. So, all right. That's all. Thank you.
Let's see. Who didn't, who wasn't here? Mr. Lucci.
Mr. Lucci. And I did talk to Mr. Lucci the first night that we even mentioned this. And he was very, very for it. And I think he would be an asset. But if he, like what was said by Mayor Foster, that if any one of you is not picked, that doesn't mean that we don't need you. And so, and we may increase the vendors on this board. It's up to the board themselves what they need. But we do need your input. And because you all come from different parts of the country and you go to different shows, and you might have some ideas that the town really needs. So please come. So don't. We don't want you, because we do want you.
Barbara, since you're the authority, do you know what Mr. Lucci vends and where he vends it now?
He does water filtering, and he's over in Rice Ranch.
Rice Ranch, okay.
He sells water filters.
All right. Okay. We're appointing someone to this position on the board right now. How do we want to do this? Just pick one of these and make a motion, or do we just...
Can I just ask one more question, please?
Yes, you may.
Mr. True?
Yes.
It says under your application, your position, I just want to clarify, I'm not sure if I'm reading it right, does it say property owner?
Yes, not here, but I rent here.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I make a motion that we appoint Mr. Douglas True to the new board.
Second.
Been moved and seconded to appoint Mr. True to the board. Are there any further discussion now?
I move that we appoint Richard Trustee to the board.
We have to vote on this motion.
That's kind of.
I'll tell you what, sir. I will make a suggestion, and that's just for that we maybe. The clerk could hand us a piece of paper and we could each write a name down, whatever. Maybe we could do it by a ballot to see who, but we actually are forced to pick a person and make a motion, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes,
that
motion in a second.
Well, they could increase the composition of this board, right?
And that's probably what's going to happen. I'm not going to say that's going to happen. That's probably what's going to happen. We just got to get one started.
Yeah. It's my opinion, too, that the board increases, because I think there should be a food vendor on the board as well, because they deal with, special items that the rest of the vendors don't deal with. So hopefully when the board convenes, it's their recommendation to come to council and approve more members.
I guess I have one more question then before Mr. True, before he vote on it. Please step back up. It's the proper thing to do. Were you here at the previous meeting when this board was discussed?
I was not.
You wasn't?
I wasn't aware that the meeting was.
Okay. At that meeting, it was discussed that after the meeting of the board, that the board would discuss extending the membership to further people, and that they then, you know, the technical way this has to happen, since the original motion was for a board of four members, the board now has to take control and vote to increase its membership. So I would ask if you would agree with that concept, that the board should have more membership on.
I do.
Okay. All right. Thank you, sir. In that case, we'll go to the vote on Mr. True. All those in favor of appointing Mr. True to the board here, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Unanimously approved. Thank you, sir. Okay. Number two. There is only one person for this position. All those in favor of appointing, or I make a motion that Skip Gal be appointed to the, from the Health and Development Services Board to this board.
Second.
Then moved to second that Skip Gal be approved. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Gal, would you care to make a comment?
Only that I also agree that some increase in the board is probably warranted. We need to only be careful it doesn't get too big.
Thank you, sir. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The next one is from the Chamber of the Proud Neighbors of Quartzsite representative, and we have two people. Would you like to stand up here and introduce yourself? We'll start with you, Ms. Gibson.
Mayor and Council, my name is Violet Kiss. I am a local resident, a business owner and vendor, and member of Proud Neighbors of Quartzsite, asking to be a representative on the vendor board for this occasion. You have my papers. I've been involved in a lot of activities here in town. I'm very much for helping Quartzsite be the best it can be. I'm very much a team member and a good communicator, and it is good to have representatives of all sides. The good news is I'm also a vendor. I have been in the past. We belong to, my husband and I belong to the CIA, to the Gem Club. In the past, before we moved here full-time, about a little over a year and a half ago, we were also members of the Palomar Gem Club in Escondido, San Diego County, the Searchers, and Needles Gem Club. My husband is also a graduate gemologist, so we're very involved with these types of things out in nature. Do you have any questions in particular?
Any questions from the council?
I don't have any.
Well, do you live here year-round?
Yes. We have been now for more than a year and a half, full-time.
Are you currently vending right now?
This moment, not. Next week at the powwow.
And you're vending gems, I assume?
Gemstones and jewelry, rough, glass, cap shots.
Okay. Any other questions? Thank you. See?
From the Quartzsite Business Chamber of Commerce. All I can say to you is I've worked with the vendors for the last 8 years. We've helped them as much as we can. We've worked with the vendor areas, people that own the vendor areas. We've always done what we could for the vendors. I don't think any of them could ever come up and say that we, you know, ever slowed down their process. But we work with them from, especially the new ones, from in the summertime all the way through the season. And they know that they can come to us with any kind of problem. And I think this is a good thing. But you do have to have a food vendor on this board. Thank you.
Wait a minute. See, yes. Somebody might have a question here.
I'm sorry.
Any question?
This isn't going to impact on your daily stuff at the chamber?
No, I don't think so. It's not like we're going to have meetings every day.
You never know.
That's true. That's
free in the evening, very much.
Yes, everybody's more free in the evening.
Any other questions? You know, I work with vendors, you work with all the businesses in town.
Yes, we work with all the businesses. Like I said, we work with the swap meet owners because we have to know what they offer these vendors. So we really work very well together.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think I'm going to make this motion. I make a motion that we appoint C. Cana Valley to the event board here.
Second.
Been moved and seconded that C. Cana Valley be appointed to the board. Since we've had discussion, we'll go ahead with the vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? It's unanimous. Thank you, C. Now we need a parks and RV. We have two members here, Danny Duke and Randy Parrish. Are they in the audience?
Yeah.
Danny is here. All right. Introduce yourself.
Hi, good afternoon. Danny Duke from Prospectors Panorama.
And you want to be on the board?
Yeah, I think it's a good idea. I've been on some boards before, and I do have some experience. My background is running gem and mineral shows, gem, mineral, and jewelry shows in every major city in the United States, in which I ran over 1,000 shows already. We had, our company had at one point over 100 shows a year. And I'm semi-retired from that business. I still own part of it. And I've dealt with about every kind of problem and situation, from somebody being shot to a fire, from a jeweler to just about anything you could imagine that took place at a show, a public event. And it's been interesting and fun, and I enjoy it. About 7 years ago, I bought Prospectors Panorama, not because I wanted to be a swap meet operator in Quartzsite, but I wanted a place to sell rocks, which I also sell rocks. And I don't know if any of you have been over to see my new building and my rocks and my museum over at Prospectors. If you haven't, please do come by and have a look and say hello.
All right.
Some of you have been over, and I know, and others have.
Are there any questions for Mr. Duke?
You're a property owner?
Yes, sir. I own three or four different parcels of property.
I mean here in town.
Here in town, Barbara can attest to that. I know she wasn't happy with her last commission, but it's tough times.
Ms. Anderson?
Okay, not a question, but a comment. My husband and I have been over to the Prospectors Panorama recently, and on behalf of the town of Quartzsite, I do want to thank you for what you have done over there. It really adds.
You're welcome, and thank you very much. I appreciate the comment. We generally try to do everything upscale, and I'd like to be a leader also.
One other question, I guess. I know you were here at the previous
meeting. Yes, I was.
Do you agree with the concept of increasing membership on the board?
You know, I think we ought to get to 7 or 9. The last board I was on was 5, I was always the odd one out, but that's the way it goes. But yeah, we definitely need food people. Maybe we need one, maybe perhaps two. And I think if we got up to, if we go over 9, I think it's going to get difficult to do anything. But I think we need an odd number. And I also wanted to say that I think it would be a good idea if perhaps one of the people or two of the people couldn't attend the meeting for a vote, if they could pass their proxy to somebody who was present.
I think in that case, the telephonic attendance, I don't believe this proxy thing works.
I spend a few months a year in out of the country. A lot of times, I drive by Quartzsite a lot. I live in Tucson, Arizona, and I do a lot of business in LA and San Francisco. And I pretty much drive now because flying is so unpleasant, and it's not that far. So I do drive by here an awful lot. I don't always stop. But at Prospectors, we do have a house upstairs, we rent the basement out to vendors, and so I get a place to stay. But a lot of times, if I'm, you know, I just get stop at Love's, get another cup of coffee, keep going. But it's easy enough to stop.
Well, telephonic attendance at public meetings is permitted under state law. So
well, that's good. So. Yeah, okay. Thank you very much. Anybody else have any questions for me?
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
And is Mr. Parrish in the audience? Does someone have his...
Pardon me. Are we not going to appoint somebody from Swatney and RV Park? So it'd be two separate. Okay.
Does someone have Mr. Parrish's sheet?
I don't seem to have a copy of it. Oh, maybe I do. Right here. Mr. Parrish. He is employed by the Scenic Road RV Park.
He owns it.
He owns it. He says employed, but yes, okay. He is background in tourism, business management. That's right. He is a new resident of town. Anyone else have anything to speak to Mr. Parrish?
I've talked to both Randy and his wife. We were out there when they had the opening of their business, and they impressed me as being very knowledgeable when it comes to business ownership. They have a good plan, a business plan. They've been successful in both Oregon and in Hawaii, although the business in Hawaii was more tourist-oriented. But I think they'd be an asset. I wish we could vote for all of these folks, you know. But the first time you make a nomination, that means nobody else really is considered.
Well, they can be considered by the board itself, Joe.
I know.
They can do it here.
Yeah.
Mr. Parrish, I know because he just came here and acquired that property. So he's a rather new resident. Mr. Duke, how long have you been in business in Quartzsite?
7 years.
7 years, okay. All right. I guess at this point we need a motion. One of these gentlemen.
I made a motion. We nominate Daniel Duke to the board.
Second.
And this one. Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Oh, and Randy Parrish. Sorry, I covered it up. Second.
It has been moved in second to appoint Mr. Duke and Mr. Parrish to the board. We've had our discussion. Time to go to the vote. All those in favor of this appointment signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Unanimous. Congratulations, Mr. Duke. Communications and citizens' petitions? Being done?
You can't speak in this from here. You have to go down there if you want to speak to this at this time.
Yeah, don't fool around too long.
I'm going to keep your arm off.
Patricia Anderson, citizen. I just wanted to mention again, if they would, well, I don't know if this is actually appropriate, I'll have to do it as a question. Could they say now if they would like to have a meeting on February 10th at 6 p.m. here at Town Hall?
You may answer that. We can.
Thank you. Okay. What we'll do is call everybody that's been chosen and get some dates and some times, and it's going to have to be accommodating to all the business people. So it'll either be early morning or after 5. And then we'll get some dates and we'll go from there.
Kind of new to this new America stuff, but... why can't the citizens ask questions at these events?
Name.
My name is Michael Roth, resident, activist, American.
we cannot answer from here. So we cannot answer questions or any citizens' comments. So.
So the citizens don't have a participation in this process at all? Thank you. Your silence is deafening.
Hi, I'm Skip Gallup, and for those other members that were just voted to the board, I make a suggestion we hang around and see when we're, if we can set up a date and a time. Thank you.
Any other citizens' petitions or comments? Being none, this meeting is adjourned.
So it isn't America.
I'll ask you a question for you. Did the council pass that, or did they sort of follow the recommendation? So
what are you doing there?
Hey, Mr. Miller, still don't even know.
Hello.